All right, welcome to the round table at the range. Today I'm here with my man Jim Chapman, the godfather of air guns, Tom Gaylord, and the air gun scientist, Joe Brancato. Guys, exciting day today. I get to take a look at an unreleased gun. First thing that's the most exciting, this gun just came out of Chacho. What's the most exciting thing about this gun? Go.
Price and features. For under $300 at $299 list, you've got a gun that's basically got everything the big boys have. It's a regulated PCP. Umarex, listen to us, guys. We're getting tired of these probes that need adapters that we lose and all that kind of stuff. Umarex put a male quick disconnect right on the bottle.
The average regulated gun costs about what?
Close to $1,000.
$1,000 to $1,500, yeah. Depends on which gun.
A regulated gun, that's a big deal. For those people out there that do not know what a regulated gun is, that means no matter how much air pressure you put in, every time you fire the gun, exact same amount of air is released. That are basically this, it's like shot number one, and you're getting 60 shot number ones within a what?
Well, the beautiful thing is, we got up to 80 with when we tested ours, but we'll go with 60. But the gist of it is, you fill the bottle up to 3,000. It's a 213 cubic inch bottle, which is a lot of air. You fill it to 3,000, but it's regulated down to 11. So that means you can shoot the thing down to 11 and you're still on the reg.
Right.
What happens after that, I didn't test it.
Sure.
But you're getting 1,900 PSI delta that you can use. That's a big deal.
Rossi, Jim and Joe are talking about features that they could not talk about 5 years ago on a $300
gun. Yeah.
We're talking about bringing value to the average guy for the first time. That's why it's the gauntlet.
The gauntlet.
Throwing down the gauntlet, Umarex is.
Reliable magazine, it's got a shrouded barrel.
10 round mag.
Yeah, those are part of the features too. I mean, it's a reliable, proven magazine design. It's a shrouded barrel. It's a good trigger, a good solid trigger.
Take me through some of the other features, Tom. What are you seeing here?
You're putting your hand right on one there. It's got an adjustable cheek piece, so it's already ergonomic.
Another thing about this rifle is these are very common, these cylinders. You can just carry an extra bottle with you. And so instead of having to carry your big tank with you, which, you know, that's a fine thing, but if you're out in the field, you might want to just throw one or two of these in your backpack.
Shall we put it through?
Let's do.
Yeah. We got a crony set up. We got targets, 25, 50, 7,500. Why don't we take 5 shots at each distance? I'll let you guys pick. I'll kick things off at 25.
Oh, that's quiet.
Wow.
814. 816.
Woo.
818. 818.
Not bad. All right, who's up next? You got 5 more shots here.
I'll go next.
All
still
right.
Shooting up high.
836.
There you go. So it's kicking up a little bit.
Just a little.
But the wind is also blowing that direction 30 miles an hour right now.
809.
Wait, did you adjust your sighting?
I did.
Ah, so you're just going for a bullseye. 80 boy. So what are you doing? Are you adjusting your sight to try to get close to the middle, or are you staying, going for a group? What are you doing?
I'm trying to pull it into the bullseye, so I'm angling down more and more.
Okay, so just so everyone's clear, he's the one moving, that's not the gun. Nice. All right, who wants to give it a shot at 75? Which target are you going for? Bottom?
I could go for the bottom, yes.
All right, bottom target at 75 yards.
It's going high to the right.
I saw that. Okay, I'm walking him in.
Yeah.
That one was the same aim point. You noticed it went through the same hole.
Wow.
Right next to it,
yeah, right next to it. Same place. This thing is incredible. I like the trigger. I like the sound.
Is it adjustable trigger?
It is adjustable.
Yeah.
And the verdict on, our highly scientific verdict on the quietness?
It's quiet.
That is a quiet gun.
Quietosity has a high rating. You want to try it?
100 yards, baby.
All right, so far the group's ridiculously tight.
Yeah.
Especially for a $300 gun.
Not bad.
What do you got?
Wind.
Yeah, we're fighting the wind.
It's impressive.
Thank you very much.
Nice.
Thank you very much. I'm done.
Woo!
3 shots, all in the bull.
Final thoughts, gentlemen.
Quiet, accurate, consistent. What more do you want? And inexpensive.
I can't think of one feature that it doesn't offer that's offered in a higher priced gun. Seriously.
Right.
The shrouded barrel, the magazine.
Yeah.
Good trigger.
Yeah.
Regulated, high shot count.
Yeah.
adjustable stock. I mean, there's not a lot else you can add to a gun.
There you go, the Gauntlet, Umarex. It's really their first PCP.
Yeah, they knocked it out of the park. They really did.
Guys, thanks for watching. Appreciate it. This is a group gun review. This was kind of fun. I enjoyed this, getting all your take on it. If you want more on this gun, go to AmericanAirGunner.com. Check out our YouTube page. Watch more videos. Keep watching the show. Thanks for being a part of this. We'll be back. Up next, we'll be talking about pellet velocity at the muzzle and downrange. American Air Gunner is brought to you by Big Blast Caps. Have a blast. By Air Venturi, the power of air, and by Walther. Built for life. All right, so here we go, guys. Out of the cabin and outdoors, what we want to find out here is the pellet velocity when it comes out of the muzzle at 25 yards. Right. Is that we've all agreed on?
That's right.
Okay, so we're going 22 caliber. This is the Walther MaximaThor. What are you guys expecting here?
Here's the thing. We're going to see a reduction, obviously, in the velocity. But what you would see, and this is what started our argument today, if you remember, that a heavier pellet may be coming out of the gun at a lower velocity, but it will maintain velocity further downrange.
We've got two different Superdomes. We've got the Diablos, we've got the Superdome for the RWS. Okay, so here we go. Those solid ones there you can see are the heavier ones. The ones with the rings there are the lighter ones. It's go time, gentlemen, shall we? So we're starting with the heavier pellet. All right, fire in the hole. 960.
964.
964 and a half.
975.
And 981.
982.
And 982, really.
That thing's moving. All right, so let's see the lighter.
1,061.
Woo!
68.
1,068. 1,071. Still climbing.
Still climbing, yeah. Mm-hmm.
1,093.
All right.
Shall we take a look? So there we go. So the top pellets are the heavier pellets. The bottom pellets are the lighter pellets. We were getting mid 900 feet per second on the top. We were getting mid
to high.
Almost 1,100 on that last one. And they're still not making as much
penetration.
It's ridiculous.
That's why the mass is so important. When factoring that in to look at the foot-pounds of energy that are being transferred over rather than just the velocity across the muzzle.
And that's right out of the muzzle. I mean, we're talking less than 3 feet.
Yeah,
right?
We're 3 feet.
This is like getting hit with a baseball versus a wiffle ball.
So what's gonna happen at 25 yards?
Okay. Difference will be bigger.
Yeah. You think so?
I do.
It will.
Yeah. Well, the good news is we get to test it. Here we go. Round two, 25 yards, same shots. All right, here we go.
This is your first shot with the heavies, right?
Yeah, 25 yards. We have lost Tyler, just so you guys know. Tyler, he's downrange. He's watching the crony, telling us where it hits. See how this all goes.
From behind protection, let's add.
Yes, he is protected. 3, 2.
925.
925 on a heavy pellet.
935.
935, heavy pellet. Moving into light pellets.
821.6.
All right, 821.
820.
820. 820. There we go. Let's go take a look, guys. Okay.
So we got two JSBs up here. So these are the heavy 18 ones.
Yeah.
Okay. Look at how far those penetrated in comparison to these guys. These are Superdomes.
The heavier pellet, you get more feet per second, 25 yards down.
More?
Yeah.
And more energy.
So all that stuff you guys talk about out there, like, my gun shoots 1,300, 1,400 feet per second, doesn't matter.
Nope.
It doesn't matter. No. This is what matters.
What science does.
As a matter of fact, it's detrimental. Because when you're going at those high velocities, you're destabilizing the pellet.
Yeah.
So everything you're doing for one reason, to say my velocity is higher than yours.
Right.
Which only lasts you so long.
And if that's your problem, you should see my wife, and then you can go on with your business. So guys, this is exactly what I'm talking about. I love this. So this is the science behind air gun. So guys, there you go. Let's just recap real quick. Back at muzzle velocity, lighter pellet was 100 feet per second more than the heavier pellet.
Right.
Right, but the heavier pellet still was getting further penetration.
Better penetration.
25 yards down the road, they switch.
The velocity,
the velocity switches, but the heavier pellet is still getting more penetration. If we go to 50 yards, it even gets more embarrassing for the lightweight pellet that at the beginning was going, I'm 100 yards faster, I'm 100, right?
That's right, that's exactly right. You got it.
No, doesn't matter.
Exactly.
You got it. That's what I'm talking about.
Let's run before the lightning and the rain
gets us. That's how you end a round table. That's it, guys. This has been a great round table and outdoor running table. We're about to get rained on. We got to go. See you later.
We'll see you.
Bye.